ओम श्री गणेशाय नमः, ओम श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः। इट्स अ कॉमन ट्रेडिशन फॉर ऑल ऑफ अस टू गो टू एनी देवी टेम्पल एंड ऑफर सारी टू द डिवाइन मदर, एस्पेशली इन टेम्पल्स लाइक वैष्णो देवी, कोल्हापुर महालक्ष्मी और एनी ऑफ द शक्ति पीठस। व्हेन वी नेवर गो एम्प्टी हैंडेड, वी ऑलवेज गो विद आवर हैंड्स फुल ऑफ ऑफरिंग्स टू द डिवाइन मदर। सारी इज वन ऑफ द मोस्ट कॉमन ऑफरिंग्स दैट वी ऑल ऑफर टू द डिवाइन मदर। We've seen our mothers do this, we've seen our grandmothers do that, and now we are also doing the same thing. While on one side, it's a wonderful tradition to offer sari to the Divine Mother, I have also seen that over years, the temples are also selling these saris as prasad to the devotees. So often, when the devotees go into the temple, they walk in and when they're walking out, their eyes naturally gyrate towards the sari counter. They see the saris, they want to buy it, they want to gift it. So this is a very common practice which is being followed. Amidst this practice being followed, there are also devotees who get doubts and they reach out and ask me, "Ma'am, is it a good tradition to actually buy sari from the temple? Because people, when they offer it to the Divine Mother, they would have had some selfish prayer or some mannat. And then will that not affect me? Because with that bhavna, they would have offered." Please remember that the moment anything is offered to the Divine Mother, everything attains purity. The moment it touches her, her idol, her murti, her being, the entire thing gets purified and energized. And then when you accept it as prasad, definitely it's also going to empower you. You're going to be more energized, more vibrant when you wear a sari, which is the prasad of the Divine Mother, which she herself has worn. So never hesitate to get it from the temple. Second thing is that it is also very good to do it as a seva, because whatever nominal fee they charge you or the price that they would have set for the sari, when you pay that, it's actually a good seva to the temple that you're doing. Just remember one thing, that don't buy the sari like you're doing any regular shopping. So trying to make the temple remove all the saris from the counter, see, spread everything, try to wear and see how it looks, and oh, it's draping very well, this is not good. Don't do those kind of things, because have some reverence for the sari. That is more than enough. The bhakti bhavana, you're taking back home the prasad, you're not taking back another sari from a shop. Just remember that. Then things will really get better for you. And what do you do with these kind of saris? Of course, I'm not saying you should not wear it out or wear it for parties or anything like that. But what I'm saying is, try to wear it whenever you visit temples, so it has the vibration. Second thing is that you can also wear it for inside your puja mandir at home, when you're lighting the lamp or diya every day. You can wear it for your sadhana, because it has the vibration. It will help you gain concentration sooner than if you would wear any other dress. And don't wash it before wearing. The very first time you're wearing it, you wear it directly, because their temples don't wash generally. The moment it is offered to mother, they just put it in the counter. So it's like you're wearing it directly from what has touched her. So it has its own vibration, it has its own energy. That is something that you need to make use of. You know, wear it for a few times and then you can wash it. Or even if you want to wear it like a party or something, then you might have to wash it, because you would have interacted with so many people and their energy and aura, there is an exchange. Otherwise, you don't really need to worry too much about it. If you're just confining it to wearing it in temples or to wear it in your puja mandir or wearing it for your sadhana, then it's fantastic. I've had such saris which are dedicated for certain temples, which are dedicated for my prayers, and it's amazing. Because the concentration is just like that. It's instantaneous and without any effort. And, you know, don't try to see which is your favorite color. Is it a good design? Is the border okay? Are there any damages? That kind of mentality, please do not have when you go and buy a sari from a temple. I have had wonderful experiences with so many prasadams which I've received from temples, because I think it's also my profession and my guru's blessings that whenever I go to any temple, most of the priests know me and they usually tend to give some sari as prasad. Not even once have I ever felt that, oh my God, it's somebody's mannat sari which has come to me and what is going to happen to me or anything like that. Nothing, it's only blessings, and I've always worn it and people have always complimented, saying there is some radiance that they can see. that it's looking extraordinary. And I always tell them it's the Divine Mother sari, which is why probably I'm looking more vibrant and radiant. So you see, it's funny that so many people ask me, what do you do? I mean, why is it that you look so radiant and things like that? I think one person even commented recently saying, you know, is it the Shukra Graha which is making me attractive? So I think it's only purely the grace of the Divine Mother. She's my Ishta Devata. Mahakali is my Ishta Devata. And whatever prasad I've received, and with great reverence I've accepted it. I've always felt it's Mother who wants me to have the sari. And it's through the Purohit that she's just given it to me, and I'm extremely grateful. So this is the attitude with which you need to accept whatever prasad. See, just use your common sense. In the temples, they usually give flowers also. Tell me which devotee offers flowers just because they want Mother to be decorated or adorned with flowers. Everybody has a selfish prayer. Almost everybody has a selfish prayer. And they always give with something in mind. And when the Purohit gives back flower to you, it doesn't affect you, right? You take it with so much reverence, you don't have any doubt, because there is no price attached to it. So the moment you're paying and then you're buying something, you get these doubts. So don't have these doubts. Don't nurture these doubts. It's perfectly alright to have the sari as prasad. In fact, I've had prasads from Kamakya Mata Shakti Peet, and I have had prasad from Kolhapur Mahalakshmi. I've had from Kollur Mukambika. I've had from Mata Vaishno Devi. Every time I go to Vaishno Devi, I pick up sari, not only for myself, for a lot of my friends and relatives, so that, you know, they get the grace. Gets, you know, instead of giving them some prasad, something, you just tell, you know, I went there, and you just give them that puffed rice, dry fruits and all that, it's fine. But this is something that they can keep for a longer time. You can also do seva to the temple by contributing a meager amount, and this they're going to remember for life. They're going to wear it, and best part is they're going to be wearing what Mother has worn, so the vibration will be very, very strong as grace. So a lot of their sufferings, lot of karma doshas get absolved, and they can they're going towards one step closer to divinity, right? So it's a very good idea to do that. I wish you all the best. I hope you all experience the same vibrations of the Divine Mother which I have experienced, and probably much more. Thank you. Namaste.